Cool. We are a go, I suppose. So, yep, 97%. I know I said that a couple times now, but I wasn't sure how Jack the Ripper would work with percentage-wise. But yep, turns out I nailed it. But yeah, when I predicted that 80, it might have been semi-close. We might have been in the mid to late 80s percentage-wise overall, but I still easily guessed it at least 10 ahead of time. As if that's something you're proud of, I guessed a percentage, right? Well done, self. Pat myself on the back. Right, so we're back 20 years in the future from Syndicate, so 1880s. Then, that's what that means. Believe so. Jacob looks mostly the same. He aged pretty well. Evie has aged well in terms of her physique, for sure. She still feels like old Evie. I mean, young Evie. So, all right, man. All right, gotta decide how I mean that. So, I think I was gonna continue the story, but I'm also debating maybe I should just do some of these because I could use money too. So, I will do that. Do you like my confidence, viewer? All right, I'll start up in the Whitechapel area since that's even though it's all level 10, I think it's quote unquote a lower level area. I think it's still slightly easier. Been quite a while since we did any questing in Whitechapel, even in the last part of the game. Okay, that's cool that that's there, but that's not what I'm here to do, is it? Let's see. Shame two. They're numbered? Okay. Shall we do the first one of everything? What's this? I guess the only one that's num well. That's number two. Oh, hey, treasures. I guess I didn't get all of them here. It Oh, right. It was the Helix glitches. Man, I really confused myself for a minute. Okay. So I don't think I could get one Helix glitch. Was that right? But I was able to get the treasure map for both areas. Looks like it also. Yeah, that's what I was gonna do. I could do these along the way, though. Why not? Okay. Also unlocked illustrations, so that's nice. But yeah, I remember I dumped 10k into those two maps. So, alright. Yep, guess we gotta. Alright. I'll get whatever I see, and which is the first thing is right there. And I'll work my way towards missions and start working on some of them. Not the main story mission, of course. Why would I ever do that? Why would I ever start with that? Gotta make money first, man. Especially having no money now. Do you run a little slower, Eevee? Or is that my imagination? Shame. 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 Shame.
She's not allowed in here. You! Stop it now!
Break a bar!
He died. Guess you can't knock them out either. Okay, so I had to kill these guys first, since they are a problem for me. Level 11 guards, hey. What's this? I'm still used to fighting guards that are stronger or a higher level than me, though, so, maybe. Oh man.
You! Stop it now!
Who do you think I am? I just invited this unfortunate to tea.
Let's see how the people of London judge your acts.
I should be able to go out because he gives me cover now. Oh. Oh man. Okay, let's stop breaking away, please.
What's that over there? I don't want to hurt you.
Walk. You win! You win! I'm yours!
all about.
Something's going on.
Don't struggle.
Looks like bother to me. Looks like it's been a killing. Maybe two.
Scream and it'll be your last.
What? All right! Whatever you want!
What's going on over there?
You win! I'm yours!
Go home, Finger!
I wonder if
anyone's
like that involved me somehow.
I don't want to hurt you. Walk.
Boo. I like how they booed him. Alright, do maximum shame, I guess. Is that the idea here? Bring him through one last crowd. There we go. Indeed it. Oh no.
No noise.
Wow, I'm glad he didn't see me. That was press space bar, what the hell? Maybe I pressed it like a split second too late or something. Where are you going, friend? Oh, now I gotta get out of here, huh? Look at these guys just going back and forth. Don't see me. Why are you following me? God, she got real close, didn't she? That's probably what just happened. Unless she's supposed to go around that or something, I don't know.
Oi, what kind of man gets his jollies hurting a defenseless girl?
Oh God, please! Let me go! Don't tell my wife!
Oh, so now you're sorry, eh? Don't you ever lay a hand on one of us girls again. We know who you are.
Much needed money. Okay. Guess we'll finish this way. Brothel attack. That doesn't sound very, very good. You know, I'll slight detour and get this chest. Good points. Yeah, where are we at in those? Can get, 2, 6, 2, and 2. Okay. But, okay. Do I need health that badly? Not really. Last longer. I'll get this for now. The other one next. Instantly get Frigg then. Come on, guys. Proofread your game. Oh, 26 points to reach your next level, so I can reach level 11 then. Can I? I see. Alright. Then 6, 6, and 6. Okay. Yeah, you have the two ones that cost 2 skill points first, obviously. Because then everything else is 6. Why wouldn't I? Alright. Ah, shut up. Is this back? Are we back to this again? Do I have to conquer the different districts again? Like, I thought I did that 20 years ago, man. Come on. Aw, shut up. Dude, really. You gotta just stop. You guys gotta just stop. One of these days, one of you is gonna piss me off, and it's gonna cost a price. Hup 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 hup. Anyway, I feel like Mia's been MIA. Haha, Mia. For about a week, which is too bad. Hope she's okay on behalf of my stream and its viewers. Viewer parentheses S parentheses. All right, let's do this one. We'll never get to level 11 unless we do all this stuff. Even though there's gonna be level 11 guards in all these places, I'm sure. Just gotta do it. Anyway, it's a test of our skills that we've acquired. Oh my god, there's a lot of cards. Holy crap.
And I've suddenly remembered I need to be elf.
Oh, bye.
She shouldn't be here.
You shouldn't be here. I'm a woman, yes. It's unfortunate that you know what a woman looks like. I was hoping you were stupider than that. Don't let prostitutes die. Okay.
Who are you hiding from, miss?
I mean, are this gonna randomly kill prostitutes, or what's the challenge there? Oh, look at you! You're so close yet so far away from me. Oh, poor guy. Yeah, pretending you're not looking for me.
What are you hiding?
Oh, I better be running before I get to runs.
I think I'm not knocking them out as quickly as I used to. Alright, are you still looking for someone, or what's the deal with you? I could kill them, I don't need to let them live. I could also use throwing knives, probably. There's a lot of guards. Maybe I'm strength that your throwing knives decreased. What's going on here? Anyway, let me just do this the old-fashioned way. I gotta take care of the roof guards first. And work my way from up to down. Always best. Oh, hello, sir. Shit, he goes up. There's no, okay. Good to know. Follow him, clockwise here. Quietly, quietly. Alright, this guy can be taken out next. Leave. Patrol back this way first, that's fine. Everything's fine here. So I have to watch out for this guy, right? Alright, let's take him out first then. That's a lot less guards now than we were first looking at over here. Now I have to figure out how to get inside properly. This guy I could have killed right there. Probably don't need to touch those guys on the outside border. Outside of the red area, rather. Face off, damn. Aggressive, no. I kill you from here, buddy.
Don't let that fry woman near the girls. Kill him if she gets too close.
What prostitute? Who's in danger? Oh no. Saved one. Can't let two die, right? Shit. It's a complicated angle here. Is that a timer thing or is that a noise thing? It's hard to tell.
You're looking for trouble, aren't you?
Keep your fucking hands up,
I'll make you no harm. You're looking for trouble, aren't you?
Stay away from me!
Don't kill
see that
me,
woman there?
Keep your fucking hands off me!
Wait, it sounds like someone else. Might be a timer thing. Okay. Man, I wish you would tell me that. That's the f What? I can't restart? What the hell am I s- Alright. Got it. I'll come back to do this. Sorry, guys. Incomplete mission here. Is a time thing, I'm pretty sure. I can't take time to kill everything. I just gotta get inside and kill the ones that are near them.
Don't look free anymore.
Ah, no, not everyone respawn though. Not every enemy. Roof guards. Alright, where can I get in from? Let's see. Here I can. First.
You're safe now.
Try it with me, miss.
Here.
Evie Fry, you have just signed your death warrant. Face me!
Don't try it with me, miss. Keep me your alone. Little hands off you me. Don't kill me. I make you no harm. Don't try it with me, miss.
Happening here.
Little does she know I still have a clear shot of her. There's not one person in this filthy borough who'd have defended us as you have, Miss Evie. Thank you.
There's been a murder. A cold-blooded murder. I can't believe me peepers.
Can't believe his peepers. Sorry, buddy. Sounds like a personal problem. What can I tell you? Just one, though, right? Not enough to get the other skill point. Or skill. Indeed. Time out a minute. Looks like no D&D tonight, as most of the players from my group mostly anticipated. Part of the reason I started. Got the turret alive. Is he at risk of dying, or what's the deal here? It's just one of those missions where I just gotta kidnap and load into a carriage or whatever, something like that. I mean, literally. What? What? Sorry, I gotta say what if I'm trying to be English. What? Literally. What? I missed twice. Oh my god. Evie, what is with the aim DLC? See, it feels different. Need to refill on knives at this point. Literally. I had it lined up, and he leaned one way for a split second. Those paws are just poor women like me and you. I've been making myself a bloody fortune. Picking pockets, robbing shops, extorting whores for protection fees. Let's see, we got both targeted, right? Really? No! Hello! Thanks for running towards me. God, that was convenient.
This is your last bout! Enjoy! What is
that? Too bad I have to continue intimidating them into remaining my hostage. Even though that was no longer an issue. In 20 years ago, we were a little more intimidating, I guess. I don't know. I know I got it towards the end of the game, but still.
Assistance, Miss Fry.
I have to re-earn my loyalty from Aberline. Man, do you forget everything from 20 years ago too? What's with all of you? What's with everything? Some dude is singing to himself. That's great. Love your passion, bro. You continue being you. Be the best of you. Un momento, por favor. I'm only semi-distracted, so give me... I'll walk towards the objective casually. Instead of just staying completely still. Oh. Well, there's that too. Okay. It's easier if I can just move straight forward. Alright. That works for me. Alright, well, it'll be faster if I just don't try to multitask here. Just give me a bit. Whoa, what, Jesus. Sorry, I didn't realize I had just a curtain covering the screen there. It's pretty funny. Alright, just one or two more minutes. Alright, sorry for the wait, just making sure I didn't miss anything. Looks like I'm good. Anyway, update for those of you who happen to see, or witness, or overhear, whatever word you want to use, the kind of blow up between me and Raj the other day. I think he's one of my viewers, so listen at your own risk, Raj. I still think at the start he was a little overly aggressive and a little too much blame shifting on some things. After a lot of thought and perspective, I still feel that way. But I still feel like he made a lot of good points. As soon as he calmed down, he started making the good points. Up until that point, it was like, well, have you ever asked me how I felt? or asked how I saw that and maybe what led me to respond that way in that instance? Like until you talk to me like that with some stuff, you know, you're not going to quite understand. Because I know how they tend to be. They tend not to jump to my point of view right away, even if... Again, not about being right. I do have recording evidence this time for some of this stuff, so... But it's more about being questioned when I'm not wrong about something. It's like, okay, can you consider a different point of view? Like, I don't know. That might be something else. So, yeah. One major thing I learned from all that was I'm good taking the break from Mark in particular. He pushed my buttons, and I think he knows he does, so I think I didn't realize it so much at first until I started looking back recently at the evidence. I was like, oh, well, of course, because he said so. He didn't have to say that, but he did, and, you know, could control my reaction, I know, but also shouldn't have to deal with people who are... not to use a cliche word, but toxic or whatever. So, kind of glad for the break, deciding what I want to do. I may be the one who doesn't want to... Honestly, I've felt for a while now mixed feelings about the four-player group. So, I may be the one who doesn't want to ever do it again. Honestly, it might have been over a year in the making at this point, looking back on some other things, too. So, it's too bad. Also, Evie acquired Jacob's 30 gun ammo capacity skill, apparently, because it was a skill. Kind of like Evie holding 30 throwing knives is her skill. Anyway, yeah, I've been good with the break. I'm feeling a lot better about spending time alone now that I have a little more perspective. That, yes, he was actually being an asshole in this instance, and yes, okay, they did misunderstand this. Okay, it's like, getting some validation and perspective on some stuff I had some issues with over the last couple months. Has really helped, actually. Not that I don't still need help for other things. Like I said, Ross still raised a lot of good points the other day when we were talking. When he started actually caring about me in the conversation, he started raising actual good points instead of stuff that seemed like bitter versus like, okay, really? Why are you getting hung up on that? Like, that was the whole start of it. He's getting hung up on something that... It's like, grow up, dude. And he's telling me to... Like, you're gonna have an adult conversation. I was like, really? You're saying that when you're starting it like this? That was such a bad start to it. he had such a better way to approach me there. But it's fine. We somehow de-escalated because I think we care about each other enough. Despite me still thinking that was a pretty shitty approach to having a conversation with me. A serious conversation. It somehow worked out. Because we're good friends, we know each other well. We put up with each other's bullshit more than we sometimes probably should, but the reason we do is the two of us can actually seriously have like a meaningful, deep conversation without don't know. It's different from what I feel like they do. Like, we try to just get to the root of it and try to understand and improve. It's not about getting upset or blaming or getting angry at someone. It's like, well, what can we do to help this situation? I don't know. So, that's a problem they seem to have with some of the things he kind of tipped his hand on in his conversation. I was like, really? You guys thought that or felt that way? My reaction was like, interesting. It was really like, if only you knew. But I was like, you know what? It's fine. That's another thing. We all have our shit to work on, was my conclusion from that. I was like, so do they with some things, apparently. But I definitely do. Probably more than anyone else. Just for other things. And I know it's, in a weird way, it's affecting my personal relationships a little bit, but not as much as... It's a part of the picture with them. It's only part of the picture. I'm well aware they have their own work to do on themselves. And only then will we really... I feel like we'll be able to fully function as our old four-player group. One person in particular needs a lot of work. Needs to resist that urge to be such a dick or just question everything. Or say everything is wrong. And Raj needs to stop taking his point of view so easily sometimes. It's like, maybe talk to me. But at least Raj listens when you talk. Usually. He has to be calm, a little calm-headed for that to be more likely, but... Uncommon thing to hear my friends try to find out how they're wrong. It's unfortunate. That's something I thought we were all learning to do as we grew older, okay. I mean, I'm not perfect at it, for sure, but... At least I do it pretty damn good amount of the time. Mia makes sure to tell me, damn. Trust me. And my Ukraine friend too. That's, again, one of the reasons I've been leaning into friendships with them. Like, they kind of try to understand me and where I'm coming from, and like, oh, well, it's not out of malice, actually. Maybe, you know. Like, okay, well, maybe instead of this, maybe they see it this way. Like, they try to think of it in ways like that, which is really useful, actually. Instead of... And saying, maybe instead of being so focused on this, because they see where it leads my thoughts, like, maybe instead, do this. Instead of saying, well, you're an asshole for doing this. Like, it's a very different approach, like, when someone else tries to tell me I'm quote-unquote wrong about something, or should reconsider how I'm viewing something, or stuff like that, so... I love Raj, I'm glad we found common ground. I would love to talk like that more, like we did the other day. None of you will ever hear that. Had to end that stream and whatnot. Didn't upload that video. But... Love to talk more like that, but I don't know. I almost feel like I'm not sure. I feel like he might have a tank of energy to do that sort of thing, and I'm not sure if it's full again. If that makes sense. Whereas I'm the type of person that, like, well, hey, since we're talking, let me deal with this too. Like, and it, for a lot of people, it becomes overload, which is true for me on some days. I didn't used to be that way, but I have some days like that now. But overall, I'm still like I always was, where I'm like, I want to fix everything as soon as possible. But I can't, because some people just never want to talk, or they get defensive, and it's hard to talk to them. And it's hard to figure out how to approach them the right way, so, you know. Get discouraged from talking to people who you can't... who you try, but can't figure out how to talk to. Gets discouraging. Yeah, that's why I'm trying to connect with different friends. So, everyone knows Mia. My friend from Ukraine is Adriana. So, Mia, Adriana, I'm trying to connect more with some friends from the D&D group, too. Slowly. one who two didn't want. Jordan, he, also a fellow Assassin's Creed fan, he watched for a little bit of this game at one point, before work one evening. Appreciate him popping in. And his wife, Michaela. They're both pretty cool, so... And they make the effort to spend time with you, which is a more important part of the equation than I thought to consider when I was younger. Like, who makes the effort to spend the time with you? Like, I had to start paying attention to that the older I got, because, you know, it makes a difference. Also, since I'm down in the City of London, I'm collecting stuff now. I'll get back to missions. It's fine. I will eventually, I promise. But yeah, like, it's just bizarre. Like, when I realized, like, when, Rajkai told me Mark didn't want to spend time with me anymore, I was like, you know, now that you mention it, I didn't really stop to think about it, but I haven't wanted to spend time with Mark for, like, a year and a half, actually, is more like it. Like, I look on Discord, and, like, the last time I tried to put in effort, like, I could tell he didn't want to or care. And that was in, like, I don't know, first half of last year. Very soon after my brother died. So I was like, okay. I put my best foot forward and said, well, if you change your mind, I'll, you know, just let me know. You know, I just want to spend time with friends. And then nothing. And somehow he swallowed his pride and messaged me one night, like, several months back when we did resume the four player, and of course I wasn't completely enthused about it, but I tolerated him at that point. I just didn't really understand how it really felt until now. I gave him a short-ass one-word response. I was like, well, looking back, this is how you treated me the last time we really had a personal text interaction. Okay. I mean, how does it feel to get it back? I just said, like, yep. When he seemed to be trying, I don't know, he seemed to be extending it all around, but I was like, okay, first of all, if you're going to extend one now, at least apologize for how you swatted my olive branch away last time. Otherwise, your olive branch is meaningless to me. And my experiences with him since then have totally backed that up. So it's a little unfortunate that my other friends don't really see how he can really be. He might not be that way with them. And, like, Raj did try to use the, you know, it only happens with you. And I'm like, you know the funny thing, Raj? Do you ever stop to ask me who in my life it happens with? Like, guess what? It's only with you guys, mainly Mark, and you kind of sometimes secondarily, depending on how much you buy into Mark's bullshit. That's usually what it comes down to. No one else in my life. So, no, you could say it's a me problem, but I could say it's a you problem based on the same logic, because guess what? It only happens with you guys. Like, no one else. No one else in my life has ever been, like, an issue like this, where, I don't know, you're so hung up on some things and wanted me to let go other things so easily. So, I don't know. The more I look back and get perspective. All right. Live and learn. But that's a conversation for another day. I feel like I would have... Rogers only had a limited capacity to listen to me during that conversation the other day, so I didn't want to blow it by saying too much about, well, here's why X and this happened, so this is why Y happened, and then Z is because, you know... Sometimes it's not worth it. That's the lesson Aubrey taught me, especially, was some people again, me included, the more time passes. Just need time sometimes to process stuff first before you get overwhelmed with too much. So even if I've been waiting a year to have a real conversation about something, it doesn't mean I can just dump a year's worth of thoughts onto someone if they're not ready for it, so... So, on the plus side, I did at least control myself in that way. I'm sure anyone who looks less favorably upon me would not quite see it that way, but... You know, it's a lesson trying to learn. Just care a little less about, I don't know, what other people think when... When you can tell it's, like, personal or something got under their skin, it's like, well, if you can't come to me calmly and rationally about this, I gotta be honest, I'm taking it a little less seriously. I feel like it's a little more personal in nature than you'd like to let on. So that tends to be my reaction to. There we go. That sort of approach. So. Yet. I don't know, somehow we ended up, like, yelling at each other the other day. I was like, what? I haven't done this for years. Like, last time I yelled, I think, was at my wife when she wouldn't tell me... When she was basically acting suicidal and wouldn't tell me where her pills were that she was going to use to attempt. And the time before that was when my parents were being a little too mean to my brother Dan after an alcohol relapse. And I felt like... It was getting a little too far out of hand. Like, those are the last... And those are both over 5 years... I feel like at least 6 years ago at this point, I want to say. That was the last time I yelled like that. Oh, well, maybe once at Kat, I guess. Never mind. My last girlfriend. Only person I've dated since my wife passed away, but... Yes, I yelled at her once. We yelled at each other. I'll be honest. I was the only one yelling in the other two instances I thought of, but Kat and I were definitely yelling at each other. So in that instance, my yelling was more in response to her aggression. It's like I don't know. We were also a little less than sober. So, but yeah, in the last 6 plus, probably 7 years or so, those are the only three instances I can think of. So, again, paint it however you want. Say it's just me. Say it never happens. You know, I could say the same exact thing, honestly. Just you. So, trust me, it's a mutual point of view. I'm just not going to piss you off by saying it to you, I guess, is what I decided on last time. I was like, yeah, it's also only you guys. So, something about this pair up doesn't get along and doesn't stop to try to understand the other side. And based on what I've listened to, I think I know where that usually happens, but I'm clearly not going to be able to tell you and get you to learn. It has to be something you figure out on your own. It's one of those things, like, I don't know, like sports players or something. You could teach them, you could tell them... A works like B. And they might understand in theory, but until they actually figure it out on their own and have a real deeper understanding of what certain things mean, like once they have like an innate understanding of something, they're much better athletes. So that not this is, you know, exactly the same, but that kind of concept. Kind of got to figure some stuff out on your own or else it doesn't mean anything. If you can't see what I'm trying to tell you, there's only so much I could do to help you. Sometimes. But Raj definitely gets credit for... Despite the shitty, immature start to our like, shouting discussion, still gets credit for being the most mature friend for actually talking to me about anything that's bothering him. Instead of just using it as a weapon against me and using it to exclude me from shit. So that was a nice thing to confirm also. It's like, okay, got it. Well, as long as I know how it's working. Okay. Where everyone's at. But I learned a long time ago what it's like to be purposely left out of a group. And it was by shittier people than my friends, trust me. I mean, at least at the time. Some of them grew up to be better people. I have my doubts about one of them, maybe two of them, actually, but I think there are, let's see, how many of them? Six or seven of them? I'd have to think of all their names slowly to make sure I was thinking of everyone. I think it's six of them. I have my doubts about one or two of them, but, they did that to me one time in, like, the most childish, immature way possible. And I was literally pointing to evidence to counter what they were, like, they tried to, like, this, like, you hear the word gaslighting and shit, man, they were trying. It was before gaslighting was a term, I'm quite sure, like 15 years ago. So I've been there with people who are shitty enough to just let their personal feelings just be used as a weapon against you and how they treat you, instead of actually trying to communicate as a human and understand, well, you know, maybe they interpret it this way because I said this, or maybe because they've been through this, they think of it this way. Like, I don't get that kind of... That's called empathy, folks. By the way, I've talked about it before. It is something they often lack. Raj less so, for sure, than the others, but... he's also better at communicating, so... You know, he has a few things going for him over the other guys, for sure. But that's what that is. It's empathy. And, that's something... That's a quality I've been trying to... Without really putting a name on it and really... like acknowledging to myself that that's a quality I'm looking for in friends, that is something I've been trying to look for in the friendships I've been making. If I really stop to think about it, because Mia and Adrian are quite empathetic people. They do try a lot to see things from a different point of view. And Mia has the benefit of age behind her, which I know some folks see as a drawback, but no, she's a smart lady. Though I don't think she would admit it, but she is. And she's a good person, so that's why I like interacting with her, because she's cool. People who are good people are cool people. Alright, last three treasure chests. Should I fast travel? I probably should. Oh, 400? I guess I absolutely should. So here's to the good friends. Raj, like me, stumbles a lot, makes his own mistakes. Doesn't want to admit them. And I sometimes won't point them out to him. We have that in common, but love him to death. At least at the end of the day, he still proved the other day that he'll at least talk to me. He had to find a shitty way to do it, but he did it. So he gets a lot of points regardless of the approach. Here's to me and Adriana, who have actually tried to understand and help me figure some shit out recently too. I appreciate them a lot. I also appreciate my parents, who I know are struggling with their own shit, and they need therapy too, just like I do, but they still try to take care of me. Like, I don't want to explain this the wrong way. Like, take this as a, like, mother-son bonding thing, but... like, she even talked about how she has just been terrible, like, about cooking since my brother passed away. For context, he lived with them his whole life. He never was able to move out because he kind of started to develop his own issues, including alcoholism, once he... Well, I guess it kind of just got worse when he moved, but he, yeah, I don't know. Without, just the short of it. So because of that stuff, he continued to work and make enough money to, I don't even know. I don't know if he paid rent or whatever. Made enough money to quote unquote get by. I mean, even living with my parents or whatever. So he still enjoyed for... easily 10 years more than me. Just the comforts of having my mom cook and take care of it, like, do his laundry and shit. Like, he unfortunately was never able... I mean, he, in other ways, other than, like, living and taking care of himself, like, he kind of... I don't know, he pulled his own weight in some ways. Like, they didn't let him just be a lazy shit. So I make him sound worse than he was, but another race, he was so mature, so insightful. There's a lot of, he's smart, he's sharp, especially when he was sober. Unfortunately, that was more of an issue in the later years, but. I looked up to him a lot. I don't know. His point of view meant a lot to me. Yeah. He was good at telling me things about myself that I didn't see in myself. Necessarily. Give me credit where I wasn't ready to give myself credit, for example. And it's interesting because it kind of lines up with something he said a long time ago. This had to be easily half a lifetime ago. I might have been around 18, I don't know. I can't remember now. It was give or take a few years, around 18, I'm sure. Give or take 3 or 4 years. So let's say 14 or 15 to 21, 22, but probably in that first half somewhere. Like, one thing he told me that stuck with me, because I couldn't believe someone would say this to me. I was like, what? I'm not, you think that much of me? He said, like, no matter what anyone else ever tells you, and trust me, I've processed this a lot over the years, because I know how it's going to sound, so let me preface it with that. But he gave me quite the compliment about my intelligence. He said, no matter what anyone else ever tells you, you're one of the smartest people. Like, that will be in any, like, anyone around you. If you're ever in a group, like, of anyone we know, like, you're one of the smartest people. Don't cut yourself short. Like, you, I don't know, like, I forget how, I wish I remember exactly how he phrased it, but he's like, you might not realize it, because I think he realized how much doubt I had, and honestly, I still have. But Ross said something like this too. He's like, he just said you're one of the smartest people, like I know. Like, if people try to make you doubt your intelligence, like, don't listen to them, basically. It's like, I don't know, for whatever reason, it was a really hard pill to swallow. I was like, I'm not, like, maybe at the time I was ranking myself based on, like, I don't know, my social standing in my school, like how quote unquote popular I was, or how well I was performing academically. I don't think Dan was, my brother Dan, was thinking about any of that stuff when he said that. It's taken me a long time to realize that. I still don't know exactly what he was talking about. Not in a way that I can put into words. I think he just... I don't know. I've started to see it in myself over enough time. I mean, I'm in my mid-30s. A lot of people know each other. A lot of people know themselves by this point. They know their skills and stuff. They know what they're good at. Blah, blah, blah. I feel like it's taken me a long time to realize exactly what I have that is so much superior than a lot of other people on average anyway. So I'm starting to see the little things. Like, I have a lot of attention to detail, for example, that's a like in a way that I can name a couple of people in my life who I think have the same level of attention to detail. That combined with, like, a sense of empathy, sympathy, just, like, caring about people, and, like, wanting to try to do the right thing, even if it's not apparent to some people or comes across the wrong way to some people, which I think is what I'm dealing with my friends. I don't think they sometimes realize I'm not trying to be difficult or like I want to be a good person and have fun all the time. But sometimes something happens that like triggers me away from that slightly. And like when I slow down to think about it, I kind of see it. I'm not smart enough to see it in the moment most of the time. I don't know. It's hard to be so self-aware. I don't know. It's a thing. It's hard. Like, you put so much more pressure on yourself than other people. Like, that's something I've tried to be aware of as well. That I might be putting too much pressure on myself, honestly. Oh, there's guards that I need to take out too. Right. But I don't want policemen around. They're making it hard to get this treasure. I don't want the treasure. Don't stop me from getting this, okay? Stay over there for a second. And you might see me go up to the roof. Maybe, hopefully not. Nope, didn't turn around. Great. Alright, well, I killed one policeman, even though it said I don't kill policemen. So, that's one less policeman to worry about. I could probably also choke this guy out, which doesn't kill him, even though I failed a mission earlier because I choked the target out. Said he died. I was like, what? Every other mission says they live when you choke them out. Why is this one different? Don't know. Alright, that guard... Don't think I was paying close enough attention to him. Didn't realize he patrolled. But he was standing by this little wall down here with the other guard. But I guess it goes back and forth. Question is, can I get him without the target noticing me? Or does it matter? I could probably just kidnap the target and walk right by, to be honest. Probably wasting time here. Let's assume I'm wasting time. Oh, but opportunity.
Excuse me! Slow down now! You do not want to upset me, young lady!
Wait, what happened? What? Why would you say that and then run away? What just happened? What? Did I scare him? I think I saw, like, a skull icon. No, there's one over... Not a skull icon. I don't know what that icon is. It's like a weird face. Let's go, my boy. Now that both guards are out of the way, conveniently, wasn't expecting that. We're not so different to you and I. What'd she say?
Jesus, all right. Whatever you want.
Hey, we don't need to bring Jesus into this.
I'll help you.
Don't
just let me go.
Oh, I don't need your help. Just go into the carriage, sir. Thanks for saying you'll help, but no thanks. Don't worry. Weird that the carriage is facing the wrong way. However, that may not have been the carriage I was quote unquote supposed to take. Let's not draw the attention of any guards unnecessarily, shall we?
Thank you so much.
No problem, whoever you are. I'm happy to serve the city folk. Ever. I don't know. Alright, hang on. I'm just tabbing out to, I want to close some stuff. Not much, so I'm ready, already. Ready, already! Alright, so 1 out of 6 skills now. Great, I need 24 skill points. 6 each skill. Where are we at? 30%. Oh no, we only got 10% up. Oh, gotta do more. Gotta do at least 20-30%. I mean, I know we're focusing on the collectibles, which is very slow progress usually. So I know that's part of it. So it's fine. It'll speed up after this. But having just the little I've done from the Jack the Ripper DLC, I can confirm that all my PTSD came from Assassin's Creed Unity. Not this game. Mostly the co-op missions that I haven't done. Those are totally the missions. Totally the missions I'm remembering. 100%. I have no doubt now. So, yeah, I conveniently just didn't do them. Didn't even realize what I was passing up on doing. Those missions that I hated doing so much the first time around. The co-op missions that I soloed. Some of them are really tough. So it just kind of confirms that I did them solo. But I don't think it was easy to do it co-op on the Xbox at the time, to be honest. It was like an idea slightly ahead of its time. It was like ahead of the capabilities of the console or whatever. Online service or whatever. It was always fun. I'm sure it was fun to do it, but... it just wasn't as easy as it should have been.
My constables and I are grateful for your assistance.
Someone get her! She just shoot like a fish!
I'm on there!
and fight to the death. Come on then, lads. That's where the real money is. Who's with me?
You're dead!
Thank you for taking another dangerous criminal off the streets, Miss Fry.
I'm not sure what... I was trying to use every spike I had. I guess I need more spike. I mean, it's not that I ran out of spikes. Hey. I may save that one for next time. Okay. Just move on to another one for now. Set that next time. For now, let me refill on everything, because, all the spikes I had there, jeez. It seemed to take two spikes to frighten people, which I think if I upgrade my skills, that won't need to be the case. I think, bombs. I went from level 1. So yes, let's upgrade it. Absolutely. Big upgrade, that's why I made it. So I want to upgrade our weapon, because why use level 7 when we could? It's better. Oh, wait, no, they're both level 9. But it's better. Oh, more attack, but less stun and lethality. You know, sure, actually. Let's be thorough on our spending here, because what else are we earning money for? Not much to buy, apparently, this time, so easy to keep up. Weapons are done. Expensive. You got a level 8 gun. That's not a big improvement. Instead, let's stay on top of these. Guns last this time. Stay on top of everything else. Not including colors. Who cares about colors? Anyway, thanks Twitch for listening to my random personal ramblings. Yeah, my childhood friends are cool, but not cool enough to sacrifice my personal health for. So.
Have a good day now.
That's why I've kind of subconsciously not tried to spend any time with Mark these last 18 months or so. It's been a very, like, sudden and stark realization. It's like, oh, like, deep down I already knew what I needed to do to take care of myself, stay away from him. So these guys are surprised that I get in fights with Mark, whereas I probably shouldn't be because I should have realized this a lot sooner. But I think it has to do with my other issues. I'm not addressing things I think and feel a lot of the time. So I feel like my body and my mind are still reacting to things for me, for my own good sometimes. It's like, that's why I always have a weird feeling hanging out with Mark, because he's an asshole and I don't want to hang out with him a lot of the time. That's why. Oh, makes sense now. Like, just hearing that he didn't want to spend time with me is like, well, wait, what did I do to make him feel that way? Just, like, be defensive to his bullshit? Then I thought about it, I was like, oh, I've actually felt this way for a while, so I've probably been a little hostile to Mark sometimes because he's been an asshole to me in the past. Like, I started to realize, ah, oh, man, the context I'm missing in my own head, even though it's right in front of me. It's nice filling in the puzzle pieces, I guess. Like, this is why I felt this way hanging out with him the last year and a half or so, because I kind of realized he was a shitty person and not a great friend a long time ago. I mean, you know, obviously I can't speak to his friendship with anyone else, but that's how he's treated me. So, you know, I can only go on what I see from him, so. Well done, sir. Way to be a shitty friend, I guess. It's too bad. Like, he and I were, like, best friends in, like, 6th or 7th grade, like, that time frame. Like, there was, like, a 2-year time span where we were just inseparable. Sure, it's so much interest in Quake Mega TF, this game called Outwars that I think he found that was kind of interesting, I think. I think he found it. I'm not sure. I might be wrong about that, actually. I might have been the one to find it, but he might have gotten into it. And, like, encouraged me to continue playing past a certain point where it seemed really difficult. That was a weird game. But, in my head, it's a very Mark game. So, think what I do about Mark, whatever. We have our memories together, I suppose. But, yeah, I miss the old Mark, who was much more ready to have a good time, much less bitter, much less defensive, much less... Unfortunately, this is where Raj was right. Unfortunately, I wish he was much less concerned about being right. That's much more his problem than mine, I think. I think Raj is missing some nuance to that for me. I can see how it seems that way from the outside, and especially when I'm being defensive. Then I'm gonna be as black and white as the asshole on the other side. Like, I end up, like, getting stuck in countering their assholism with an equal level of asshole. You know, well, if you're gonna be black and white about it, I will be too, even though I should know better. Like, that's what I'm saying about I need to control my reactions. So, but at least I know that. So I hope, or at least I've learned it at some point along the way, even if I'm not great at doing it yet, putting it to practice, at least I know that. So I hope Mark can someday learn that level of self-awareness. I don't think he looks inward enough. So for those of you viewers who do like our 4-player group gaming, sorry, it's probably going to be very unappealing to me until he starts figuring some of his own shit out. I know I have my own shit to figure out, and that's what the guys think is the problem, and, you know, they're welcome to think that way. It's fine. I know better. I'm aware enough to know that even though I have my own issues, they do too, and even if I work out my own issues, they're gonna still need to work out theirs before anything's gonna happen. So, I at least know that much. But, again, it's one of those things you can't really tell someone because they're not going to listen to you unless they kind of realize it for themselves. Kind of what Raj pushed me towards personally the other day was, I mean, I wasn't going to listen to his bullshit, but I did at least acknowledge the stuff he was right about that I do need to see and acknowledge in myself that I do need to work on. So he came from the right place. But like he said, he's not a therapist. He was very quick to blame some things on me that were, in retrospect and upon video evidence, clearly Mark's fault. It's like, okay, well, I'm sorry you were so easily persuaded to believe the bullshit. But it's whatever. It's one of those things, like, control my reaction. It's fine. It's not worth it. Gotta decide what fights are worth it sometimes with people. Which I would hope would be how they would have thought about me, instead of thinking I'm just an asshole who wants to be right all the time. It's like, well, maybe don't question me when I'm not wrong about something, and maybe it won't seem like I care about being right, because sometimes I actually am right about things, and you guys question it anyway. And it's like, well, where? Why are we here? What are we doing? Ugh. All right, so great. This is good. 76% on miscellaneous. Yes, I'm happy with that. That means we've gotten so much of the collection done. At least 3 out of 4 of everything on average. So, I know I've gotten almost all the chests, all the heal stitches. So that's good. Seeing I thought I got the locked chests. I guess, oh, there are areas I haven't been to yet. Oh, that makes sense. So I am done with chests in both areas. Great. Done with illustrations completely. Missed a heals glitch in the City of London. That, since it's one, that is tempting to go for, I have to be honest. I don't like leaving him on. Ah, it was that close. But, all right, for now, let's finish. Oh, I gotta go this way. Leave me alone. I can't kill him.
This is not what you think, please. My reputation will be sullied.
Let's see how the people of London judge your acts.
I almost killed him. Almost strangled him. The optionals are always easy, I guess. Or straightforward, at least, on these. If not easy, at least straightforward.
I don't want to hurt you. Walk.
I get past this guy without being seen. No, 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 no. Get back here. No. Get back here. Shoot! No! Get back here! No! What's happening? No! Did you? He just fell through the world. What just happened? What? What? No! That's not fair! Don't bug out through the world. That's not fair. Come on, that's not fair. Come on, come on, come on.
This is not what you think, please! My reputation will be sullied!
Let's see how the people of London judge your acts.
We're going to take a walk,
you and I.
Ah, you win! You win! I'm yours!
Let's go around. Let's not go around the long way this time. Let's go in the proper front entrance this time. Pay attention to me, sir. It's for your own health, trust me.
Ah, you win, I'm yours. Good work, man.
I thought it's been a killing. Maybe two.
Now we're to our last crowd. We need two more crowds, actually.
Let's do this the easy way.
One. For the traffic jam. Wait for this guy to move.
Bravo, miss.
Oh no. Just don't fall through the universe, please. Stop trying to get away, sir.
What's that then?
I wonder if anyone's been killed.
I don't want to hurt you. Walk.
But it's been nice and therapeutic to be able to talk to the stream, actually, unexpectedly. Sorry to air my personal problems with my friends, but it is nice being able to talk about it with some freedom, though, on the other hand.
Did you think you could treat us like dogs just because we're dollies?
And no, someone is probably hearing it at some point, I don't know.
I won't do it again.
You'd better not, if you know what's good for you.
I still think Raj is my viewer right now. So, good for him if he actually goes back and listens to all of this, but, cool. That wraps up this area except for the one optional I messed up, but nice. Good progress. So if I continue finishing all the optional stuff. Just leave story stuff. I mean, everything increases percentage by a lot, I guess, in this. So, and I'm not getting as far as fast as I would like. I would like to finish this tomorrow. I was hoping to finish it this weekend, but I haven't been playing enough. I haven't been getting on earlier in the day to play. I've been playing D2 with Raj. Damn you, Raj. I mean, it's fine. We've gotten a lot done. Had a good day today, but damn. Oh, I also failed to hijack the carriage in this, apparently. I do kind of remember that. Alright, let's continue these red areas, I guess. Thanks for the skill point. However, I cannot use it until I have 6. Hey, thanks for following me. Why isn't it... Oh. Nope, my phone app is not telling me who followed me yet, so thank you, whoever you are, for following me. I apparently can't tell who it is yet. Probably tab out and see. So, let me do that. Oh, Mia. You are always in my, like, three most recent followers. Even though I have almost 30 followers now, you're always in my three most recent followers. Hello. Mia, you missed a lot. Yeah, well, because you unfollowed me. I mean, you... my point is, you constantly unfollow me and refollow me. It's like a very back and forth thing. That's why you're always in my three most recent followers. You're always in my three most recent followers. So you just reset the counter again and confirm that you're still in my three most recent followers. I was wondering if this would be the time where you stayed subscribed or followed. But nope. Guess you unfollowed me at some point. I was wondering who I... Wait, no. Wait a second. I looked today, and you're still on my list of followers. What the hell? Hey. I looked like this morning, because I noticed I lost a follower semi-recently, and I wasn't sure what it was, but I saw your name still on my followers. Huh. Unless it was just not updated there. I don't know. Well, yeah. Well, regardless, Mia, I have a lot to catch you up on if you're finally here. Dude, you missed a lot, Mia. And I can't even direct you to a video of the last sequence of the main story because the capture didn't work out. So even if you wanted to, you couldn't see me do the last mission now, which is too bad. I could redo it, but I did finish the main story. I killed Crawford Stark. He's dead. And the Templar threat in London was ended. So you're watching the Jack the Ripper DLC. This is 20 years in the future. So Jacob and Evie in their 40s now. Jacob has disappeared for now, and we're not sure what's happened to him. So Evie is here trying to figure out what happened to Jacob. Jack the Ripper is around. But yeah, I have 97% completion in Syndicate. This is a separate percentage, this story. So this has its own percentage. So in Jack the Ripper, I'm at 33% completion right now. So it's pretty fast. Obviously, it's not about the main game, but yeah, I've been, I collected stuff already, so you don't have to worry about watching collection. I finished collecting everything in Whitechapel, and I missed one Helix glitch here in the City of London somewhere. I think they're supposed to appear on the map, because I don't think you need a map to buy a map for them in this, but I don't see the 16th one. Regardless, I'm working on the, Whoa! Oh my god, what the... What the hell just happened? I think the... Oh my god, what? What the hell? I think the carriage that was attached to this horse just, got launched into space. And I think it choked this horse out. And killed it immediately. Holy shit, what the hell just happened? all right, well. That aside, there are two missions I did not 100%. I'm probably not going to do them tonight. I was thinking up to this point. I may change my mind, but for now, that's what I'm thinking. So, there are two optionals I've messed up. But it's fine, not a big deal. This is a new mission. Don't make you look at what? Oh, sorry, the delay. Hard to tell what you're talking about when you say stuff like that.
Save me, friend, Missy. I'm begging you. She's nothing but another whore gone missing for the rest of the
world. I'll find her. I promise.
So this is older Evie, by the way, if you want to see her face right here. So, definitely in her 40s now, being 20 years later.
Let me go!
I could not switch to Jacob if I wanted to.
There you are.
Wait, do I... It says to go this way. Did I locate the right one?
Slowly now.
Nope. Guess not.
Mercy! Help me!
Oh, come on, Evie. What's with this? Come on. Her aim is... questionable here.
There's been a murder!
Save me! Here! Over
here! Easy, easy.
So I still don't locate it, so it's not that one either. Okay. Love to upgrade this tool. However, I cannot. Oh, I found her, apparently. Mia, hang on, time me out for a second. So you're watching, right, Mia? Right now? I mean, obviously. So I only have one viewer. I had one viewer before he showed up, so it's bizarre how it switched from one to one. I thought it was Raj this whole time. I thought he left my stream up and wasn't actually watching, but maybe I was wrong. I have no idea why I had one viewer. That being said, I do have quite the update for you if you care to listen. Personally speaking, I mean.
There you go.
Oh, wait, I need to go in here.
You're safe now.
I can only repay you with my heartfelt thanks, Miss Fry.
I had quite the intense conversation with Raj, like 3 days ago or so. He kind of came at me saying how, like, some of the other guys, mainly Mark, who's the one I've had an issue with recently, have had an issue with me. Like, caring about... he brought up a few things. Some things are right. Some were like, well, Maybe you should ask me how I interpreted that. It was good though. It started out intense and a little immature. I was surprised we got into almost like a screaming match on stream. Thankfully, I don't think anyone was really watching, so I ended the stream and didn't upload that video. It was also during Diablo 2, which is not a game I care too much about. But he got really hung up on me talking about the money I had in D2. And be like, oh, well, I have this much now. I can kind of move some here and here and do that. Then kind of wait. He's like, wait. But you said this, right? I was like, well, yeah, but that was kind of like partway through my process of thinking. Like, I clarified to say this, and for whatever reason, he got hung up on what I said in the first place, even though it may have encapsulated some level of misunderstanding about what I was planning to do with my money in that game. It's almost weird to have to describe it in this level of detail, but he got hung up. He's like, "This is recorded, right? But you said this," and oh, no. I was like, "He's like, the problem is you care so much about being right." I was like, "No, like in this case, it's not. That's you're just basing this on a false premise. You're not." I can have a conversation with you if you think that's what I meant when I have clearly said since then that's not what I meant. Like, and he started getting into like it was like a few minutes of I have it recorded, but I'm not gonna upload it anywhere. But it was a few minutes of back and forth. Like, he was like, "If you want to have an adult conversation," like he took it there. I was like, "Dude, like you started this conversation like that, and you want to say if you want to have an adult conversation." And even tried to throw in, he's like, "Dude, I'm a director for like Warner Media for blah blah blah." I was like, "Yes, I get that you're successful and you make six figures, and I don't even make half of what you make, I'm quite sure." "I get it. However, what an idiot you are if you think your personal relationships are so comparable to how you handle your professional relationships. Like, what?" Like, don't pull that card, because that makes you look even worse. Like, I grew up with you, dude. Don't pull that card on me. Like, I know you still struggle with personal relationships. Don't try to say you're a successful people manager when I've seen your failed personal relationships." But I didn't say that. I held my tongue because by the time he threw that in there, he was starting to calm down a little bit. So I was starting to listen a little more, and I was willing to entertain the idea of not responding to every little detail. Because I didn't realize it later, but it's because he's not really right about me caring about being right all the time. Sometimes, maybe. Sometimes I might be a weird stickler about that. Like, I feel like the one time you said, let me tell you, because this involves you. There was one time you said you saw a message that a guy was running away, and I said I didn't see it. I was like, "I don't know what to tell you. I didn't see it." Like, I don't know. I don't think it happened, but maybe you're right. I think I didn't say that at first, but I still said it eventually. But look, the more I look back, the more I'm like, you're probably right. You probably did see a message saying the guy was running away. I probably did miss it. Like, that's the last time I could remember being hung up on something stupid. That it doesn't matter whether I'm right. But I dug my heels in and was like, "No, Mia, it didn't say it. I'm not that stupid." I think I was that stupid. I think you're right. But that's the last time I remember caring that much. So, like, I looked back on some of the arguments with Mark, he's the one who I guess Raj brought up more than anyone else as having an issue with me. And I'm like, "Yeah, of course it's Mark. Because he's the asshole who pushes my buttons and like questions me when I'm not wrong sometimes." Like, he was the one who like didn't believe me when I was like, "Dude, you know like a top and bottom thing is like also like a dom like sub thing." Like in like BDSM circles, right? Like, he had no like he wasn't willing to entertain the possibility that was true. I was like, "Dude, trust me." Like, I guess I I guess I've experimented or learned about more. Listen, I'm not into the BDSM scene. Let's not learn too much about me. I know you're saying duh. That's from that night on. I was like, oh, my vanilla boys. Oh, you guys don't know. Oh, you don't know, do you? I always think when I think of that, I always think of them as my vanilla boys. Oh, you boys, you haven't experimented a whole lot, huh? Like, he like, decided to tell me I was wrong, instead of, like, oh, I didn't realize that was what it could mean. And, like, I feel like that's the instance that Raj was referring to. It was, like, Dave and I were, he said, Dave and I were saying, they're, like, what, oh my god, like, they're going at each other. Like, I was, like, because I was trying to tell him, dude, every time I've heard the term, in my last 15 years of life, it's been in that context. I don't know what to tell you. Like, it's not something I am interested in doing, I guess. At least at this point in my life. Not that I would tell you if I was, because that's kind of personal. But trust me, that's what that means. Yeah, I don't know, dude. Like, he had to resort to linking an Urban Dictionary link that he was like, no, it means like a homo who takes order. I was like, that might have been what it meant, but that's kind of like using the term fruit these days, like calling a gay person a fruit. Like, that's such an old term at this, like, it's so outdated. Like, really? Is that really what that was the thing? Like, and I feel like that's what Roger's referring to when he was, like, you guys are going at it, and, like, you guys both cared so much about being right. I was like, we didn't talk about the particular instance he was referring to, but I was like, you had to have been talking about that, because it got unexpectedly heated, despite the fact that it was about that subject. It was bizarre. I was like, are we really that hung up on a top and bottom conversation that we're getting that passionate about it? Like, it was bizarre to me, but I swear that's the only thing I can think of that Raj is talking about. That was pretty funny. That was really funny. Yeah. Oh, I'm getting messages. I don't know if anyone wants to spend time with me or anything. I'm rambling on stream, so maybe they're listening. Uh-oh. Rob's doing D2 runs. He wants me to join him. I'll think about it. But you just joined, so I don't really want to quit right away. I don't think he's watching right now anyway, but... Yeah, it was a great conversation. No, Mia, you're gonna stoke a fire if you do that. Don't do that. I honestly even hope Raj doesn't randomly tune in or watch this later and see. Listen, you're gonna like. I tried to tell them. I was like, trust me, guys. Like, I'm trying to tell you because I, like, it's, my late wife, love her to death. I guess I'll reveal this about her. She was a little more interested in that kind of stuff, so I know what those terms mean in a modern context. Like, you can say what you want to me all day long. But, like, the fact that I know that, and the fact that you're confirming it on stream with me right now, it's like, come on, guys. Like, I appreciate you trying to tell me I'm wrong. I'm sorry if you don't want to believe it. Like, that's the only thing I can think he's referring to. So it's like, I was like, Raj, if that's the example you're using, in the back of my head. not a good one, because that was an example where I was 100% right, and Mark questioned me being right, and I was only defensive because he was wrong. He shouldn't have questioned whether I was right, because I was, and he was totally wrong. Like, why wouldn't I be defensive? Do you want me to say I'm wrong about something that I'm not wrong about? Like, should I say Hitler wasn't real? Like, what are we doing here? Like, what kind of person do you want me to be? It was weird, yeah. I was like, come on, guys. So when he said that, I was like, okay, so clearly not only do I have stuff to work on, because he did point out a lot of ways that I have had issues. let's be honest. Let's not. No. It's not worth it. It'll piss them off. I told you. This is why I can't talk to them about stuff sometimes. Because they don't listen sometimes. They don't want to be wrong, and they throw it at me that I don't want to be wrong. It's like, well, how am I supposed to say that back to you now? Because now it seems like I'm being petty. If you say it first, even if I know the truth. But Raj did point out. I want to get to the more important point. Raj did point out that I've been ignoring my personal problems a lot. More importantly than my friends being idiots and having their own shit to work on, I'm an idiot and I have my own shit to work on. So trust me, that's not a criticism that is exclusively leveled at them. It is directed to me as well. But the way he approached me and some of the points he brought up, I was like, dude, you guys have your own shit to work on. I was like, I definitely have my own issues. I'm depressed and shit. I need to see a therapist. And Raj said something that struck a chord with me. He was like, the Eric I know. I know you call me Shade, but I also know you know my name is Eric. He said at one point, the Eric I know is not the Eric I used to know. And I knew what he meant by that. He didn't mean that I changed because... Obviously, I changed because of the passing of my wife and brother. But he meant how it affected me and how I just enjoy and interact with life has changed. And he's right. It has changed. It's been a little worse recently, and I've noticed it too. So, the way he said it was when he slowed down. He stopped being so aggressive and he started talking to me in a way that showed he cared about me. And that's when I really started listening. I was like, okay, well, now you're making valid points more so. I was like, I feel like I needed someone to tell me that I'm not the same Eric that they knew. And that... I mean, obviously I'm not. Again, obviously shit happened to me. And he pointed that out too. Like, you know, obviously. He's like, I wouldn't wish what happened to you on my worst enemy. But he still said from a very caring point of view, and it was very apparent that that I'm not the friend he used to enjoy spending time with as much. But to his credit, one of my friends had the balls to tell me that. I needed to hear that. I guess. SA2. That being said, I needed to hear that from a friend. B, he's still trying to spend time with me. Even after that conversation. Well, he's talked... I'm responding to your message immediately as soon as I saw it. He's talked to me about it before. He said he thought I should see a therapist. And I agreed with him. That was a few months ago. He's like, I think you should probably move on it before you move in with your parents, honestly. I think it would help you if you did. But, you know, depression being depression. I didn't. Didn't move on it. But that conversation had an effect on me. So, the good points he made are good points. And I heard them, and I'm considering them, and I know I need to do more than I'm doing myself and my mental health. So, and I also have the perspective to know that Raj is still, you know, I was starting to prop Dave up as my best friend over time, but it's because it's been too long since Raj and I had a conversation like that, or we just were honest and vulnerable and threw shit out on the table. It would have been better if he wasn't so aggressive at first. But I feel like we made it through the shouting match and calmed down because we've known each other so long. And because we... At the end of the day, I guess... I feel like we love each other. We're friends. We could probably be honest about that if it came down to it. As difficult as that is for guys. I don't know. I would be honest about it. I'm glad... It happened, because I needed that. Like, that's a problem with guys a lot of the time. Like, I didn't realize how badly my friends would fall into the stereotype in adulthood. The guys that don't communicate emotions or whatever. I feel like that's what I've been missing. Like, I used to talk about feelings and thoughts and perspective a lot more with people I was close to. But maybe I didn't want to push buttons or, I don't know, ruffle feathers, whatever the phrase you want to use is. So maybe I scaled it back with them once I reconnected with them later in the years. I don't know. Like, a lot of it is probably unconscious thoughts that I didn't really think about, but kind of decided out of a sense of self-preservation or something. I don't know. You know? Again, another reason I should talk to a therapist, right? Because some of this can get pretty complicated, I guess. I might, but if I do, you have to promise to come back. Ask him how long he's going. He didn't ask me if I was willing to join him. He just said he's doing runs in D2. He wants to make me an unstoppable necromancer, which is the class I'm playing in D2. Which is good. It would benefit us a lot. If I was an unstoppable necromancer, I could really carry anyone through the hardest difficulty in that game. So I think he knows that too. Anyway, he messaged me like 10 minutes ago, so I shouldn't just wait. No, don't leave though, because I don't. I asked how long he's going, because I'm not. I don't want to leave if he's gonna quit in 10 minutes, because it's league time for our league addicts. So let's not keep them from their league. I mean, I'm saying that in a joking manner. Raj has definitely made the effort to spend time with me recently, that has cut into their potential league time, which is new. He hasn't done that until this last week or so. So I think his thoughts and emotions about our friend group came to a head, and I think he was ready to do something about it. But I think he doesn't want, even if the four player group doesn't work out necessarily, I think he doesn't want to lose any of his friendships. So I think he still cares about spending time with me, even if I kind of suck sometimes and have issues. I think he gave me a really nice compliment that he always thought I was one of the smartest people in our graduating class in high school, even though my grades didn't reflect that. I was like a B+ to A student depending on the subject, so I did pretty well, but I was still only like 20 something in my class. I wasn't valedictorian or anything close, but he said that, and my brother said something similar like half my lifetime ago. He said he thought I was one of the smartest people amongst our— No! Oh no! What have I done? No! I don't like this mission! No! I can't do this! No! No! What am I doing? No! No, I don't want to do this! But these don't increase. It's just bombs. He's afraid of that. This could help. I don't have this yet. No! I didn't know I was going to do this! No! Can I... I don't want to. All right, hang on. I don't want to do this mission right now. I'm not in the mood for this mission. Okay, hang on. I'll do other missions. I don't want the Fight Club ones are not as fun right now. I will come back to those. They used to be more fun when I was Jacob and just punching enemies. They're a little different now. So, all right. That's something I want to mentally prepare for. and or look up, even. I tried my damnedest on the other Fight Club to get 15 enemies frightened, and I only got 13. Anyway, thanks for listening. I appreciate you, always being willing to listen and care. Before you showed up, I did have a little Mia appreciation here and there. Because I was rambling a little bit about stuff earlier in the stream. Not too much. I'm trying to scale it back a little bit. But I'm also trying to just be open about my thoughts and perspective. Even if no one's actually listening, I think it is a little therapeutic, so I was trying to talk about it, even though I know there's a chance Raj or whoever will listen to the stream later. But yeah, I express appreciation for you and Adriana. You two have been kind of rocks for me recently, so it's been nice. So I appreciate it. I think that's Raj messaging me how long he expects to be. All right, let's ignore the Fight Club. Was that 3 messages? Damn, Raj. Not long, hopping on 7 days, but we'll be on later. Alright, so I'm probably not gonna... Alright. I'm not even gonna respond then. well, alright. No, that's... Sorry, that's how old me would have responded. Let's respond. Yeah, he's hopping out 7 days with the other guys, which I feel like I was bitter about at first, but damn, don't need to slam the door like that. Damn, calm down. Oh, it's almost 9 o'clock at night. Damn, relax. Sorry, an apartment neighbor, I don't know which one, door slam. Yeah, I responded. I said, I'm gonna continue playing this then. He said, not long. Goes for 7 days, so I was like, yeah, I'll keep to this then. One thing I learned recently, not only just talking to him, and learning how that Mark felt mutually about, like, one thing I kind of talked about to myself was how I, after talking to Raj, I kind of realized he said Mark had an issue with me, and that's part of the reason we haven't been doing stuff together, and he's been struggling with that and trying to figure out how to reunite the group. While I was listening to him say that, I was like, you know, now that you're mentioning that, I feel like I've had an issue with Mark for the last year and a half. I feel like I've been tolerating him for a long time. Now that you mention it. So, a weird side effect of that conversation was the fact that I realized, you know, I'm kind of glad I haven't been. I'm kind of glad I didn't join them, because every time I think about Mark and the interactions I have with him, like, it's negative. Like, he introduces discoloration into my experiences. I don't know, how else could I put it? that's good, right? That's a good way to phrase it. Like, it's bizarre how he can kind of... He can make things feel more stressful or less enjoyable. It's like... Why would I want to be around that? So, part of me has realized I want to spend less time around people who are, like, toxic like that. Like, I went back and watched some of the videos that we had a disagreement on. It's like, well, you know what started it was when he said this. He totally didn't have to say that. He totally could have been like, oh, well, okay, here's this. Instead of sighing or be like, what are you talking about? It actually means this. This guy, you'd think he'd have a little more diplomacy as a cop, but yeah. I've come to the conclusion that I'm I'm kind of glad it worked out this way, even though I didn't realize it at first. This time to myself and building a healthier space for myself, whether it's alone or with friends like you who care about me a little more, who care about me enough to ask how I'm doing, ask what I think about this or that. You don't just like see me say or do this and be like, okay, what an asshole. Like you'll question me, and like that's what I valued in my friends over the years. Like I don't want people who just tell me I'm always right or never question me. Like I want people who hold me up to a certain standard. You know, I want people who care about me too. I don't want someone who just holds me up to a standard and doesn't give a shit about me. Obviously, but yeah, I don't want friends who just agree with everything I say. What kind of friendship is that? It's a sycophant. So, like, that's why when I hear those bullshit accusations, like, I always care about what's right. Or being right, rather. It's like, I can kind of get how you would see it that way, having been an observer of politics and how easily some people are fooled into thinking some things that aren't true. I could see how you'd believe that if it was framed a certain way. Anyway, give me a minute. I need to go to the bathroom, but be right back. Yes, men. Indeed, yes, men. Yes. I have, since a relatively early age, gravitated towards women, not because I have ulterior motives, but because I appreciate the fact that, by default, for whatever reason, reality has proven that women have more empathy than men. Thanks, men, for sucking. I would love to talk to guys who have feelings and are willing to talk about them. However, that seems very rare. Thankfully, it's changing. Slowly, as everything societally does over time. Very slowly. But it doesn't help me now. Let's be honest. So that's a big part of the reason I lean into my female friends. So, I mean, you know, sexist or not, let's be honest. There's something a lot of you have that a lot of us don't have. And I am someone who's aware enough to know that I need more of that. And I am that way. So I like when I find people who are that way. So it's like, okay, well, every one of them who feels that way is female. Okay. That's cool. I'll take anyone I can get. Wish I had someone who is a little more like me. It's nice to share that with someone, but I'll take whoever I can get. And that's not a slight on you, since I started to realize it started to sound that way. I'm not just using you as a friend because you're whatever I can get. I hope you don't take it that way. I appreciate anyone who has empathy and a good heart. Okay, I know you're being sarcastic there. Ah, you like the less emotional stuff. Whereas I experience too little emotion from my friends, and I need people who can think more outside of that box. Is that what we are? We're just trying to get what we can't get from our respective genders. We just seek out whatever, you know, we're missing in our lives from a little of an exaggeration. Obviously, I'm not seeking out whatever I'm missing in my life from random women, but... Londoners have heard that there is a suspect in the river murders. They're looking to meet... This is the wrong word. Aw, man, come on. This is the wrong meet. It should be M-E-T-E. Meet out their own justice. It's not M-E-E-T. This is the second typo I've caught in the Jack the Ripper DLC. Come on, guys. What English person did you have proofreading this? Come on. I mean, I know how to kidnap someone, so okay. Seems like that's what it's describing to me. Can I get past these guys without being detected? I swear I'm not the Ripper. Bring me to Scotland Yard and I'll prove it. Please, please just get me to the yard alive. Oh my god, I really can't... I gotta be really careful. No, 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 no! No, no! No, I'm going! No! I lost the carriage! Okay. Apparently, anything you do in that increases... their awareness of you. Okay. I do very careful in that carriage. I can't touch anything. Okay. But what if someone's chasing me? Then what do I do? How am I supposed to not be obvious and aggressive? Well, we'll see if this is a mission I feel like doing tonight. That's what it's going to come down to. Anyway, for whatever it's worth, I do appreciate the empathy I get from you and from Adriana. Makes a big difference for me recently. I appreciate it. Just having anyone who cares about me. So I've been missing you the last week, I'll be honest. So I'm glad you're feeling okay enough to watch. Thank you for your assistance. My neighbors will hang me if they find out I have anything to do with the murders. No, no, that appeared in front of me. That's bullshit. That's bullshit. Killed him a little quietly. Not bumping into things. You bumped into me, asshole. Damn it. Stop. Stop. Why is everyone driving? There's a carriage on fire. Why is everyone driving? Why is everyone driving like a maniac? Dude. My awareness level is already... I've already failed this. Look, my awareness level is nothing. This is the worst. Stay undetected. Yes, I'm clearly undetected right now. Do I look undetected? I don't think I'm undetected. Maybe it's just me. I'm pretty sure people see me right now, but I'm not sure, you know? Maybe I'm wrong. God Damn it, my gun is empty. Gotta fight you on the friggin' roof. This guy's shooting me! Stop shooting me! He has my carriage now! Now what? Okay, nope. Nope. Nope, 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 nope. Not doing that. Yes, I lost the carriage, because fuck that. I don't even know what happened there. That was awful. I mean, come on, can I? This can't be that hard. Wow, I'm not far away. Holy shit, I got far. A lot farther than I thought. I thought it was a lot closer to the start. That's really extra frustrating. Shit. Stay undetected. Yeah. Easy. Easy, I got this. Listen, you know what? I'm gonna knock out everyone before I start this mission. How's that? Can you all just be knocked out, please? You know, including you. Get out of here. You could just die, actually. Fuck you. Not even on the mission. Just die. Nope. I want to take this guy out. And the other guys. Can you guys all just die? I know I'm not supposed to kill guards, but just get out of my way, please. I can't do anything. Can I just... What? Okay. Yes, I know I didn't kill policemen, but you guys are assholes. Get out of my way. I knew there was a limit. God, I can only kill two policemen? Or maybe I need to wait a certain amount of time between killing each of them? Honestly, I'm not sure how this works, because this is different from the main Syndicate game. You can kill cops in the first game. Listen, I only kill them when it's justifiable. Which is, I'm sure, how cops feel nowadays when they kill random civilians. However, they're usually wrong. And they don't always carry body cams. I have recorded evidence.
Get away from me before I cut you into ribbons!
I'm of the mind that cops should have private insurance, and anytime they have an issue with a person and a judgment is found against them, that it goes against their insurance and it raises their premiums. Kind of like doctors. Like, why don't cops have the same system as doctors? Because it's not a secret. Cops abuse their power sometimes. So if you're a good cop, you have nothing to worry about, right? You won't abuse your power, so your insurance premiums wouldn't go up, right? Right. Be a good cop, you're good. Done. Easy. However, the bad cops, who are pieces of shit, maybe it wouldn't turn out the same way for them. Maybe they would get insurance hikes because they're shits who just kill people because they feel like it. You know, it's such an obvious, easy idea that would take care of so much of the bullshit police brutality. I love Mark, even though he pisses me off and I don't want to hang out with him anymore. I love the guy. Somewhere along the way, he lost his sense of logic about that. And his ability to criticize bad cops and shit, bad behavior from cops. It's like, well, you clearly got purchased and owned by the police, by the NYPD. So, it's a small part of why I feel the way I do about Mark, actually. But it is a part, I guess. Like, I could see it in his behavior and his responses sometimes. Like, you're clearly shaped by your career in the last 15 years or so. It's pretty obvious in some ways. Oh yeah, definitely. Confirmed by both Mark, Dave and Raj. As much as I might want to say they might want to take Mark's side more often than mine sometimes, at least they don't say that about me. They regularly admit how intelligent I am, but they'll regularly admit how unintelligent Mark is. Dave has said more than once how black and white Mark's thinking is. Like, yeah, I guess that's fair. Like, I never thought of it that way, too. Mark has a hard time seeing the gray area. So, that's not even a judgment I made. The gray area thing. Or black and white thing. That was 100% Dave. I was like, oh yeah, that makes sense. Still sees me, shit. I don't want to be seen or captured. Asshole, come on, you don't drive like that. Wait, deliver the suspect to there? Are you kidding? It's right here. Wait, what? Oh, that's not right. Now what? Where am I supposed to go? What happened to the marker on the map? Where'd it go? Where am I going? Uh-oh. I mean, I had to go this way. Wait, the mission failed? Are you kidding me? Wait, what? I see the quest icon again. What the hell? What happened? Dude, this mission is starting to piss me off. Like, when it starts doing shit like this... Oh, the other cops are back. Shit. Yes, I can only kill two. I know. I killed the other two this time, not the same two. Also, me, I'm not sure. Let's see. Unfortunately, I forgot what I said, so I'm not sure what that was in response to specifically. Yes, in a lot of ways I'd rather just be disappointed than confront Mark, yes. If that's a question you're asking, yes.
Help me, please.
I've learned what it's like to question Mark, and that it's usually not worth it. he really makes it an unpleasant experience for you. Like, he's not like me, where he encourages someone to disagree, potentially. Don't see me. Bye. As I run to someone again, it's the same thing that happened last time. But the waypoint hasn't moved to a weird spot. So if I go around the red area, does it work this time? Well, yeah, it's hard to, like, how do you tell someone that they're like that? Like, that's a problem, especially someone who doesn't want to hear it. My awareness level is so low. What is this? Why is this happening? My awareness level is nothing. What the hell? Oh my god! Dude! I'm not doing this mission. I'm not doing it tonight. Fuck that. How's that? Fuck that. I want to kill you. Shut up. Goddamn, you suck. The amount the awareness level just dropped from tiny bullshit. Yeah, good. Die. Fuck you. I don't care about arguing and winning all the time. I would rather just avoid that. It's like, what? Can we just, like, talk? Do we have to argue? Like, say all day long I care about being right, but I don't really want to fight with anyone. If you really took a second to get to know me and talk to me, you would understand that. Like, I don't really want it to come to that. What the hell? That's so stressful. I don't really want to deal with that. Can we just talk like adults? Like, that's usually what I'll say if anyone talks to me about anything. But no one does, because everyone stops growing up in high school. They forget to keep growing up and becoming an adult and learning how to communicate your problems with people in a mature way. So it's like, you know, alright, fine. If you don't have the time to grow up, I don't have the time to deal with your bullshit. I don't know. What am I gonna say? I don't know. Shit. Lady O's thugs have taken their place. Alright, if I'm doing one of these risks, I need to be fast. I learned this about the last mission that involved saving prostitutes.
If you lot likes all the nice jam we get free around here, cut off Miss Fry's head for Lady O.
Fast, fast, fast. Otherwise they start killing the prostitutes. Me? Who said that? These prostitutes want to be prostitutes? I don't think you really understand the problem here. If you stop to think for a second, you might realize these women don't necessarily want to use their bodies for profit, but, you know, society is society, isn't it? You know? I don't think so, sir. You know, you grow up enough, you start to learn these things. You don't just judge people by their profession, for example. You start to be like, wait, what's the underlying reason for this? You know, it's called empathy. I know it's a foreign concept to my friends. And, oh, you guys want to kill them? Okay. I'm not gonna let you do that. I'm kidding.
You're safe now.
Try, guys. You failed. These might be prostitutes, but I'm not gonna sit here and judge them.
You think you could just walk
if I think I know how, if I think I know how things were during this time period, I'm the idiot. So are all of you guys. So I'm gonna kill you. Including this guy. I've also learned with these missions, I don't need to be careful. I can be careful. That's what I should say. I don't need to be reckless. I can find a window or a rooftop and kill this guy without being detected. If I can manage it. Promise finding a window. An inn that isn't on the bottom, which may not exist. To be fair, I did come in on the bottom, so I don't know that there is an entrance higher up than the bottom. Okay. Guess I have to go down. Jump over that. Evie, you've lost some agility, haven't you? You're not willing to jump over the banister, huh? Too bad. To be fair, such a banister didn't exist in the first game, but still. Oh, a window. Oh, does this mean it's a vantage point to kill? Why, it certainly looks like it. Alright. Let's see, where can we go? We can stand on that thing over there. Oh, we probably have to run up from the bottom. If it'll let us. Apparently it's not. We can only get out from the front or the back. So let's try the back to start. Doorway here. There's a guy staring at the doorway, so let's kill him first. What? You guys, come on! That's not fair. That's not fair. That's not fair. Also, by the way, I don't know if you were here for the start of the start of the stream when I was complaining about this, but these are level 11 guards, by the way, which are new. Previously, the highest level was 10, so they added a level for this. And I'm still level 10, so I do have to struggle to compete a little bit, but I'm used to fighting guards that are a level higher than me, so it's fine. Love you, you die. Love you too, also die.
We shan't forget what you've done for us, Miss Evie. Us girls will breathe a bit easier without those bastards controlling our lives.
You're welcome. Sorry you have to lifestyle. So you have a complete mission though. So let's do, instead of those two, we'll continue this way. Because those two pissed me off. Hey, I almost said John Pfizer. He's just missing the F and the Z is in the wrong place. Is this the father of the drug cartel, basically, that controls prescriptions in the U.S.? Or one of them, anyway. John Pfizer. Except it's, I guess, Pizer. Trying to hide your real identity here. Did the real descendant of John Pfizer pay the developers of this game to change his name from Pfizer to Pizer? Wait a second, this looks very similar to the last one. This is not the same one, but it certainly looks very similar. Dude, why are you mixed in with guards? Why? Why are there red guys here? If I kill him, I'm gonna have to kill you guys. This sucks. Why are you making it so hard? Don't let these guys wander around, man. They undetected. Yes, easier said than done, because guess who's looking at me now? The regular guards are watching me. Are we going to do this again now? Hey, awareness level. There's so many people in front of me. Okay, can I move? Why can't I move? Am I stuck? What's going on? Why can't I move? What's going on? What's going on? Can I move, please? Move, please? Can I move, please? What? What? Oh, I need to wait for that guy? Okay, I just can't touch anything, apparently. Nothing's going on. We're moving, buddy. Don't you want me to move you towards your goal? What? What do you mean, what's going on? So this is, I really can't touch anything. Oh! Oh! Whoa! Okay. This is a lesson in avoiding every obstacle you could possibly avoid. That's what these missions are. You gotta avoid touching anything. Okay, so you gotta really do the opposite of everything you learned to do in the original Assassin's Creed Syndicate. Sir, I would like to move past you, sir. Well, of course you made me knock down a pole, sir. Of course. Thank you.
Slow down. Go on.
Why am I aware? What? I know, what the hell, right, Mia? Damn. What the hell? I'm going too fast. Speed affects it too. Okay, so slow down.
There you are.
That's a good speed, right?
Easy, easy.
Dude, don't run into my path, dude.
Atta girl.
It's a good speed. Seems like it so far. Nope, too fast. Slow down.
That's it.
Deliver.
Thank you for bringing the suspect.
Yes! Okay, so I can do these, and I learned something.
Oh, we're dead. We're no way to prove my innocence if it weren't for you, miss.
I'm happy to help, sir. I'm glad I figured out this mission, because that will help me with the other mission. I know I need to avoid literally anything that I touch now. Anything that I can touch, I should say. Okay, good to know. Good to know, good to know. Alright, all weapons, gauntlets are, let's see, purchase and upgrade. I'm going to buy all the guns if I can afford it. I can, just barely. I'll buy them all. Won't upgrade any, I'll just buy them for now. Making money pretty quickly. These missions are giving a lot of money, but I also need to succeed at them. So, now that I know how the carriage works, I could try that one again. It's also the third one in that sequence, so maybe I'll save that for last. So, maybe let's go for that one first. That being said, I am, about to load up a bowl of smoke. I'll bring up another point. Raj did point out that the guys notice sometimes when I'm less than sober. He seemed to attribute it more to smoking than drinking, which is interesting. Because I feel like smoking is probably not the problem. Smoking definitely chills me out. But drinking makes me a little more willing to complain about shit. And be a little more open about shit than I'm not like an aggressive or angry drunk necessarily, but man, when I drink it definitely makes me more open to talk about shit that might be more beneficial to hold my cards close to the chest sometimes. Yeah, chattier is a way of putting it. But if I'm being honest about how it affects me, then definitely disadvantages me a little bit in some ways. So hearing him point that out was like, oh, that's kind of how I started to feel about my brother at one point when he was, I don't think it was just drinking though. He had some other issues simultaneously. But I was like, damn, if you're saying that, shit. Probably a sign that I indulge a little too often. Don't encourage me too much. You're saying I'm fine based on probably a fair amount of effort for me to appear that way a lot of the time. So I appreciate it, but I do still have some work to do. I should drink less. I should smoke less. I've never let it infiltrate my daily, like, anything other than the evening, early night, or whatever, early slash late night. Yeah, I've talked about that. Listen, I'm just trying to be honest with myself because, unlike my friends, sometimes I think, anyway, I would like to see them present evidence to the otherwise. I would be very happy if I did, I'll be happy to be proven wrong. But unlike my friends, I feel like I tend to take that kind of criticism a little more to heart. So, I don't know. The fact that Raj noticed, or said that it's been noticed, like, okay. Can we go over this? Okay, thank you. I want to get to the shop, so down we go. Evie, I feel like you're not as good at descending as you used to be. Anyway, well, yeah, that's my point. I mean, and I kind of, man, in a weird way that I really shouldn't do, I patted myself on the back that he thought it was just from smoking. I was like, either I do a really good job of not appearing tipsy, or you guys are just not that great at picking it up. I had to be honest with myself about that. I can pretend to think otherwise, but that's the truth.
Thank God you're here.
I will talk to you momentarily because I want.
Have you seen my friend?
Oh, she was running away. All right, I'll pause. Yeah, it might be true that they can't tell the difference. Which, again, I don't want to cling to this too much, but there is some truth to it. Just the fact that they, man, they just haven't been through the same shit I've been through. Like, if they can't really pick up on that. Like, if he's noticing that much, I feel like he should be noticing more, and or they should be. Because I'm definitely tipsy most nights, I feel like. But I try to pace myself so I don't appear that way too early in the evening. But I definitely drink a little bit every evening. And I try to stop it before it becomes a problem. I don't always succeed, but almost always do. So that's why I don't consider it as much of a problem, but I'm still self-aware enough to know it is, because I shouldn't be having to think about that in the first place. I know. I'm pretty self-aware, despite what anyone might think. It kind of helps when someone who I care about points it out to me, too. It's like, well, hey, slow down. Like, I don't know. That makes sense. Nice that someone cares about me, but isn't being like, well, you're a dumbass for doing this. But even thinking about that makes me wonder how I treated my brother towards the end, because he would sometimes join. Like gameplay sessions with in a less than ideal state of mind, I suppose. So I'm like, I'm starting to. I know he was worse than I was though. He drank all day. I've never got to that point, and if I do, I would really start to be scared for myself, so I intend to never get to the point where I drink any other time of day. Because that, to me, that's when it becomes a problem, is when I can't resist drinking any time of day. If I can keep it to the night, they're like, alright, well, it's still a problem, but it's not as bad. But I can't even justify it that much either. I still need to consider what that means. And the implications of that, so But at least I know it's an in-between step, so I'm like, alright, well, at least I'm not a, like, full-blown alcoholic, I guess. No, it's not like I've skipped a day and a half, like, a couple days here and there. You know, every now and then, I definitely skip, just to confirm that I still can. Also, because I don't want to spend as much money as I do sometimes. So I literally just purposely, like, set up the times where I just can't drink, so... I know it's different. I know it's different. It doesn't mean it's not a problem, though. It doesn't mean it's not something I can't improve. But that being said, it makes me really sad that no one intervened with my brother. Even if they saw it over the years. I don't know. Clearly had more of a problem than me, but... people seem to care more about me. Maybe I have more of a support system at this point than he did. I don't know. Just, man, wish people cared more about him. Might have made more of a difference. But I shouldn't say that, though, because... well, as always, it's complicated. I'm already reconsidering what I said because of other circumstances, but... your stepmonster with wine for breakfast. God, I really don't like the idea of drinking earlier in the day than the evening. Like, before 5 p.m., it's like, my brain is like, drinking that early? So, that give me a little measure of confidence, I guess, for whatever it's worth. But, that being said, I'll be honest, I did offer to morning or day drink or whatever to in order to hang out with Adriana and drink with her, because she is 9 hours ahead, so I could start at noon and it would be 9 p.m. there for her. She did the same in return for me a month or two ago when she was between jobs and she had a week off. She used that Saturday morning to try to drink and hang out with me. I was like, oh, I owe you now. But I haven't had a chance to do it yet. But anyway, rambling. Anyway, I'm talking a lot because I'm not used to having you around. Like, a lot to catch you up on. Why are you attacking me? Why are we doing this? Why are we doing this? Why am I even killing you? Why would you attack me in the first place? What's wrong with you? Leave me alone. I'm an innocent civilian. Why would you attack me? I mean, I'll help you as soon as I refill. Damn. Where's my hidden blade? Why am I just punching everyone? Anyway, I've been trying for weeks to convince Adriana to let me day drink with her. But she's a busy person as the R5 of our guild, our alliance.
I'm pleased. Come take a look at what I've managed to conjure up today.
Damn, I've never drank at work or before work or... or anything like that. I mean, I think I day drank once with Aubrey, my late wife, by the way, for those who don't have context. I can't even remember who was with her. I just remember day drinking once, and I remember hating it. Like, it was the worst. Like, I was like, where in my evening? Like, I felt like shit in the evening. I was like, what the hell, man? And, I feel like I probably drank enough water, but probably not. No, probably not. So if I did morning / day drink with Adriana, just so she could drink at the same time at nighttime for her, I would totally be... I would have a ton of water. I wouldn't overdo it, because I know you can die from drinking too much water, so I wouldn't overdo it, but I would totally be drinking a lot of water if I was day drinking, because, ugh. I know how it can ruin your evening. Ugh, gross. Like, that's why the addicts drink all day, because they don't want to suffer the consequences in the evening like I did.
Just took me friend! Slimy bastards! If you don't help her, no one will!
I'll find her. I promise.
I'll find her. Where is she? Her footsteps, what am I looking for? I don't see a quest icon. There one is. I don't know why I'm going that way. This way it seems closer. Anyway, I don't really want to lie anymore. Or try to hide, so... I'll try to be more honest about my state of tipsiness. So, I'll be honest, I'm tipsy right now. I've been drinking enough for that. So, maybe the more I can admit it... Wait, help me. There's no timer, though. So, can I kill... Oh, this is where I have to identify or find her in one of the carriages. Hang on. Let's see. You don't see me. Oh, I found her. Nice. Yeah, you say that, but you don't tell me often enough, Mia. You should tell me more often when it's obvious that I'm tipsy. I feel like you protect me from that, for my own mental health sometimes, even though it's better for my short-term mental health, but not as good for my long-term, probably. You should tell me when I'm obviously tipsy, but maybe not in the channels. I don't maybe in the channel. I don't know. Like, I know I've resented you for pointing it out sometimes. I don't know. I guess I gotta think about that. Regardless, you have to admit, even if I'm tipsy, I'm still not bad at gaming. I can still play this game pretty adequately. Oh, this is one of those,
That's it.
Okay. Oh, really? Wait, I have to open the door still. Oh no, these guys. Oh! Did I get you? No, not quite. Stay close. Just leave me alone. Nope, can't do it. Gotta kill these guys. Oh, dodge a bullet. Hey, buddy, where you're trying to go past the carriage? Oh, look, another one. Oh, try to dodge. Oh, hey, love you too, buddy. Oh, there's two of them. Oh, you shot your buddy. Ah, don't kill this guy first. this guy's. Oh, he debarked. Good. He's ignoring me for some reason. Yeah, run him over, bitch. No, it's running. Go. No, come back. No, it's running. No, get back here. Why are you running? No, come back. No. Hey, yes, this is running. What do you call this if it's not running? What the hell? This is crazy. Get back. Get back here. Fight me near the carriage, sir. Oh, it's still moving. No. Oh. Hey, what am I gonna throw a knife at you? Hey, ready? Oh, oh my God, this is. What are you doing, man? Oh, that was awesome. That was great. That was really funny. Oh man, that's pretty funny. Good job, sir. Just stumbling out of your carriage and just, man, you just set me up. I appreciate it. Thank you. That was pretty funny. I mean, I'll go along the outer wall for a bit, but it seems like it's inside. Okay, never mind. R? Anyone? Can I use R? Why is it so weird in this game? I have to run up to the wall, I guess? That's always a guaranteed. I need 6 skill points to spend... any. So, I need twice as many to use any. Every skill takes 6 skill points right now. Each of the 4 remaining skills takes 6 skill points. I'm not even in the zone yet, but it looks like it might be a prostitute. I mean, it looks like it's, Oh, hey! You die too. So before we start the timer on this, let's kill a few guys on the outside.
Looks like oh, wait! Nope, here we are.
We're here. Okay. On the other side of the wall? What? Oh, I see. Fast, remember. Sir. Oh no, I made noise. Come on. I don't want to pick the body up. Get out of here. I want to free these. Alright, go to her. Free. Alright, downstairs we go. Come on, ladies, let's go. Next. Dead. And. Dead. And. And ready. Huh, dead. Alright, this floor is clear. Next, let's keep moving. Can't stop moving. Where are we? Whoa, where's the stairs? Okay, well, here we are. Ah, it's nothing about math, Mia. You wouldn't have known if you just spent 6 skill points. Choking her. Stop, sir. I don't appreciate that. Go this way, please. Let's not climb on seats. Evie, I know it's fun. You're channeling some Arno energy there. Let's not do that right now. Not the time or the place. Please. Please. Okay, that guy saw it, so go investigate. I'll kill you too. Deja vu here. Dead too. Did I see anything? Now you guys can't kill enough prostitutes. I can't fail the optional if I save this one. Hey.
You're safe now.
Done. But yeah, you wouldn't have known about the 6 skill points for the skills, so. Another leader that I can probably sneak out the top to kill. I know I came in the top on this one, actually. So I can do that. From one of these rooms. Okay. On the other side, so let's go up and over. Oh, that was a slight bug, but that's fine. Don't have time for distractions, including you, sir. Only have one knife left. Gotta hit this. Stay still, stay still, stay still. Oh, got him. What's this over here?
There's no one person in this filthy borough who'd have defended us as you have, Miss Evie. Thank you.
Ah, gotcha. I didn't realize you saw that. Yeah, I have no choice. Every skill that remains costs 6. So I can't get a skill until I have 6 skill points. Great. Another one down. Alright, that only leaves 3. The 2 I was starting to get pissed off at. And this one. So let's try this one. I promise I would try as many of these as I could at the start of the stream. We're resuming story, so I will do that. The last one I need to try. I will go back to everything, including the ones I did not 100%. Just not tonight. So I'll do this and then I'll go back to the story mission tonight. By the way, I'm looking around because I still haven't found the last helix glitch in this zone. So if you're wondering why I'm looking around like a maniac trying to find stuff, I'm looking for the last helix glitch. Don't know where it is. It's the only one I need. Unlike in the main story, I'm missing like 5, which is still pretty low considering. But hey, who are you? Shut up. I'll put you in your place, bitch. Oh, you're here too. Maybe don't assault random people. Just saying. Alright, another carriage of justice. I could probably kill two police. So here's one. Oh, I missed. There's one. Gotta escape because they, noticed me. I have no idea when up, though. It's time to start this mission? Maybe. Probably. Let's do it. Let's be quick. Play. Go. Now. No waiting. Go. 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 Why can't I move? Why can't I move? Wait, why couldn't I move before? What do I have to do to fix it? What did I have to do to fix this last time? Oh no, I can't move. Why can't I move? I tabbed out. Alright, now what? Alright, can I... Alright, here we go. Don't look at me. No! They looked at me. They saw me. No. No, this is bad. Being spotted is just bad. Slow down.
Easy. Come on.
They wanna kill me!
Out of the way.
Go on.
What's on fire? What the hell?
Roll there.
Yeah, I was like, where's the fire brigade here? Come on, there dudes. There you are.
There you go.
Oh, we're good, sirs.
Here now.
Whoa! Should've known another fire brigade was gonna pass along. Stay on the right side this time.
Easy now.
Slow. Well, this is easily avoidable if we're going slow like this. Yep. Okay, can't go in there for some reason. Okay, that's fine. Awareness level has stayed pretty consistent because we've been slow and very intentional.
There you are.
Random horse, that's cool. I feel like that's a bug. I feel like a car just exploded into oblivion. That's why there's a horse on the ground.
Go on.
But I'm trying not to cause any damage here, because I'm like... I was like nudging up against that other carriage there. Not gonna make me screw up. Nice try, but no.
Slowly now.
So what should I do here then with these? Should
That's
I
it.
Wait? What's
oh, please just get me to the yard alive!
What should I go this way?
Here now.
Okay.
What was that?
Guess that's fine.
Roll there. Slow down.
Please don't let them. Please.
Go on.
Thank you for bringing the suspect to me safely, Miss Fry.
Yes, sir. Alright, I feel like that other mission will be a lot easier now. Now that I know how to
prove my innocence if it weren't for you, miss.
Drive these. I guess that also was the one I tried first in this area was also the hardest one. I think it's like the level 3 mission title or whatever. Yeah, City of London slow carriage escape 3. So that's all right. It's only 2 left, but I did say, and I did mean, that I wouldn't do those tonight. So let's do an actual Jack the Ripper story mission, shall we? So we got another gauntlet. Let's get out of the carriage because we can't do anything with it once we're on level ground. And let's refill on stuff. Done all the optional stuff at least once, or attempted them at least once. Done everything we could basically... I'll clean up next time. Bit of a detour for a shop, but you know, it is what it is. I know I'm not missing too many knives, but I used a few med packs, and those are a little harder to come by. Or, not really. They're a little less useful. Used to be. I feel like that's intentional. I feel like it's like, oh yeah, Evie's older. So, you know, won't heal her as much. I lost all my med pack, or med kit, whatever, skills. So, I don't heal as much. For sure.
Excellent choice. Hope to see you again.
So I need them if I can get them. I can carry. What can I carry? I don't even know. I should have looked. Either way, on to a story mission, finally. So, you didn't see Jack the Ripper in the first session. Oh, let me see my percentage, by the way. 42, doubled my percent. I was at 21 at the start of this. Yes, that's the minimum I was hoping for. But they do a pretty good job of making him appear a little scary and a little insane. You have to control Jack the Ripper at the start of this. Ah, there's a shop right here. Did not need to detour for a shop.
She's bagging off.
Aw, man. Frightened enemies. You know, I was thinking about quitting soon anyway. Man, this frightened stuff is getting annoying. I gotta be honest. God, so many optionals are frightened. Oh, this is a new zone, too. Man, alright. Maybe I'll reconsider starting this for now, since I did get to 42%, but that is heavily based on miscellaneous and associate activities, which are drawn out in story missions usually. Alright, I wanted to get to Origins this weekend. I don't know if it'll happen. If I'm ending tonight at 42%. But I'll at least be close, I guess. I'll be really, really close. God, man. I was hoping to move a little faster, but it's fine. It is what it is. See all the types yet. Yeah. Fight Club. Yeah, I could play something else. You know what? Raj is probably still playing 7 days with the other guys. He can still tolerate Mark somehow. Whereas I have a hard time with that. You know, it's again, in retrospect, it's a big reason why I didn't join them in the first place. Aside from the fact that I got the late notice. It's like, well, you're telling me as soon as you guys are about to start playing, and he's like, oh, no. And it's like, well, no, that's exactly what happened. You talked about it the night before, and you only thought to tell me, like, right before you guys were about to start, so there's no chance of me joining at the start. Like, okay. At least Raj thought of me, but that was still a second thought. So, I also am not interested in spending time with Mark. So, it was a mixed bag of emotions, that whole thing. But, alright. Making good progress here in Jack the Ripper, so. But I told Raj I would do something with him if he didn't quit too late, which means around now, because never split the party runs tend to be around an hour. So if he wants to do anything with me, he knows I don't like going past 11 p.m. here, which is, as you know, hour from now. Oh, hey, this if you want to get a closer look on 40 whatever year old Evie's appearance, here she is. Doesn't take as much time on her hair. Nor should she. She spent a lot of time on her hair, considering. Oh no, clicking return to the main game made it really, like, quit and, like, reload the game. I didn't care that much to go back to the... I was just gonna, like, look at my percentage in progress or whatever. But it's like reloading the game completely. Oh no. Is it even streaming the right thing? Let's see. I think it is. Changed. Alright, I mean, since it's loading, I'll make sure I stream it, but I'm just going to show you roughly the progress we ended up at. Nothing special, really. I mean, I think every category had 100% except miscellaneous, which is collectibles. So, yeah, it really came down to just finding shit on the map. So, and the great part is, I predicted I would end at 97%, but I think my prediction was right at the start of you not watching. And then a few sessions passed, and I ended at 97%. I was like, hell yeah, what a good guess. young Eevee. That's the Eevee we're used to. You haven't aged 20-whatever years yet. But she still moves like she did at this age, so good for her. Despite appearances, she doesn't go invisible, though. That ability disappeared. So that sucks. No more invisible Eevee. At least in the Jack the Ripper DLC. But if we resume this, then she's still got it. Spends a lot more time on her hair, as you can see. How much time does it take to do that? Every single day. Every single day. Man. Yep, 100% story, 100% associate activities, 100% London stories. Not 87, 88% miscellaneous. Yes. We're only missing 5 Helix glitches. 2 in City of London, 2 in Whitechapel, 1 in the Strand. I pointed this out on the stream earlier. And the music boxes called Secrets of London, which I would buy, but even after completing every single sequence, I still don't have enough Helix points to buy it. And I'm pretty sure that's what happened the first time I played this on Xbox, and I was like, well, screw that. Stopped playing. So that's pretty much how I feel now. Like, I wish it would have ended me with 1,000, because that's what I need to buy the map. Why wouldn't you give me 1,000? I'm totally not doing this. Sorry. Anyway, so if I ever feel like wandering around for Helix glitches or the music boxes, that's the only thing I have left to do in this game. So it's actually, I'm pretty close to 100%ing it. I can find that stuff if I literally just went left to right, up to down, on every little area on the map. But you can also do that in Assassin's Creed 1 for the flags, if you remember that. I was starting to use a map for that, but then it started to be unreliable. I was like, wait, I checked every spot. I don't want to get caught in that trap where I'm trying to be like, wait, I'm going this spot on the map, this spot on the map, this spot on the map. Nah, not worth that kind of time. That's from my alliance in the mobile game that I share with Adriana. Sorry, it was one of our rank fours. Sent a message, tagged us, so I was looking. I'm not super active in that mobile game, though, so it's nothing like Genesis, for the record, Mia. I think I've pointed that out before, but it's still true. I'm still very slow to be very active, because it can be very time-consuming and or costly. So it's more fun to just tag along for the ride for people who are willing to still have me in their guilds or alliance. But yeah, I guess I mostly play it because I don't know, because I still have it in common with her. I admit I probably would have lost a lot, if not all, my interest, if I really think about it. If it had nothing to do with her, I suppose. But as I said on stream yesterday, I'm trying not to let that relationship get carried away. I might have felt more at first, but I'm trying to rein it in a little bit. So the chances that anything could possibly work out from that are slim to none. So try to be like, okay, just friends. Gotta kind of keep it in that context. So just for the record, I'm trying to like redirect my thoughts in that direction a little bit. Anyway, since I did quit, let me end the recording.